Hello, this is from Irvi, and today we are going to learn Versailles measurement of railway track. While traveling on a train, you must have watched a coach or locomotive of a train moving on a curved track. So have you ever wondered how much maths goes behind for making a train move on a curved track? How do you think we measure the straightness of a straight track? How do we think we measure the radius of curvature of a curved track? There is one simple method which you must have learned in your primary school. If there is a curve, draw two perpendiculars. The point of intersection will give you the center of the curve and the length will give you the radius. To be more precise, you can even take a third perpendicular. But if there is a slight deviation from keeping these lines perpendicular to the curve, it will result into erroneous results. Further, the railway tracks are not laid on the planar surfaces. So now, how to measure the straightness of the straight track or the radius of curvature of the curved track? To do this, we will introduce the concept of Versailles measurement. This is a curve corresponding to which AB is its chord, M is the middle point, and the distance between the perpendicular distance from the midpoint of the chord and the arc is known as Versailles measurement in railway parlance. Now, getting deeper into mathematics, this is a circle of radius r, and this arc is subtending angle theta. So this distance is r sine theta denoted by x, and this horizontal distance is r cos theta. So this distance, which I earlier called Versailles measurement, is denoted by y, and that is equal to r into 1 minus cos theta. This 1 minus cos theta is a trigonometric function which is called Versailles. So r Versailles theta is y. Now x is equal to r sine theta, and using sine theta is equal to 2 sine theta by 2 cos theta by 2, x becomes this. Now y is r into 1 minus cos theta, and using 1 minus cos theta is equal to 2 sine square theta by 2, we get this value of y. Now dividing the value of y from equation number 4 to the value of x from equation number 2, we get y by x is equal to tan of theta by 2, and from this we get theta is equal to 2 tan inverse y by x. Now putting this value of theta in equation number 1, we will get r is equal to x upon sine of 2 tan inverse y by x. Now see the beauty of this equation. We have only two variables on the RHS, that is x and y. What is x? It is the half of the chord length. And what is y? It is the Versailles measurement. So by putting the value of x and y, we can measure the radius of the curvature of the railway track. So now let us simulate this on a curved track. This is a curved track, and these two points are the stations, and this middle distance from the midpoint of the chord and the arc will give the Versailles measurement for this particular station. So now, to remove your confusion, the whole railway track is divided into strategic locations. These are stations, and please note that these stations are not your normal railway stations where you board and deboard from the train. While measurement, one should note that the difference between Versailles measurement of two corresponding or two adjacent stations should not be more than 4 millimeter, And secondly, the deviation of the Versailles measurement from its design value should also be less than plus minus 3 millimeter. Now, these are the very basic instruments that we use in Versailles measurement. This is a holder, and this is a nylon or fish wire, and this is the measuring ruler. Now, let us, more of theory. So now get into the field. Here we are keeping the holder at station number 4, and the another holder is at station number 6. And this is being done to measure the Versailles measurement at station number 5. And from here, by just looking above the scale, note the reading, and this will give you the Versailles measurement for station number 5. In this way, we can take the measurements for various sections. And at last, thanks for the efforts of all the team members.